Working as a nurse in the war was unlike anything I've ever done before. Our duties went beyond tending wounds and illnesses. Our hands worked hard, but our hearts worked harder. Wounds went beyond flesh and blood. It was the tormented minds of the soldiers that we tended to most. Often cries at night from memories of war, where only sung hymns of old could soothe their troubles. It was our gift to them, our way of thanking them for their service and sacrifice. When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot thou hast taught to say, it is well, it is well with my you to have some water, okay? Yes, the others are still sleeping, so I'm going to keep my voice down as I take a look at you, okay? It's not a problem. Here, drink some water. So I just want to take a look and see how you're healing, okay? You just sit back and relax, and I'm just going to take a look at your wound, your shoulder, take your temperature, and see how everything is going, okay? I know you've been having some hard nights, okay? I know. And it's not going to go away right away. But know that I'm here, and the other nurses are here as well to help you through this. And the most important thing is that you get some rest, and this will help you heal and really recover, okay? Yeah. Okay. So your wounds are looking like they are up just fine. I don't see anything suspicious for potential infection. Yeah, I think everything is looking quite good. I am going to change your gauze. Just make sure we put some ointment on the burn, okay? just want you to relax your jaw. You were clenching quite tightly when you were having your nightmare. So I just want you to take a moment and take a big, deep breath in and just allow your shoulders to fall down to your side and allow your jaw just to relax and not resist. Good. Very good. Okay. Good. And just know that you are safe in your bed here at the ward, and that everybody here is to help you get through this, help you rest, and help you recover. So I just want you to open your mouth, and I'm just going to take a quick look. Okay. Very good. And I'm just going to press here on your tongue. Good. And a little bit. Look at your shoulder now, and I don't want to cause any discomfort, so I'm just going to slowly work the muscles here on your neck, and then I'm going to try and rotate the shoulder that was injured, okay? I know you were just sleeping, so I don't want to move anything too fast. Sore. Okay. I'm just going to feel your shoulder a little bit on the top. And it's a little bit raw. I can see that. Okay. Okay. just going to try and rotate it a little bit and see how you've been responding to the therapy. Okay. Okay, so just try and lift your shoulders to your ears. Okay, good. And again. Very good. Quite a bit. Okay, and now I'm going to put some resistance on your shoulder, so try and do the same thing. Now I'm going to just take a look here at your wound, okay? I'm going to just slowly remove the gauze off of the wound area and just examine it. Yeah. Okay. I'm just gonna see here. I'm just going to look here at this wound. Alright, you can just rest your head in my hands, okay? Going to have to put some ointment on that. Yeah. You have quite the aftermath of that mustard gas, so I want to make sure we treat that and prevent any further infection. How are you feeling? Yeah, I know it's hard. And imagine what you've gone through. But we will get through it together, okay? Okay. Alright, so I'm going to make sure that we tend to this appropriately. Massaging your shoulder area and really getting the muscles relaxed around your shoulder, okay? Good. Thank you. going to open a new package here. So now I'm going to apply fresh gauze over the wound. So the bandage bad dreams. Well, I'll do my best. Okay, my dear, I'm going to listen to your heart. And I just want you to relax. Okay. Good. Okay. Okay. And can you take a deep breath in? And a deep breath in and out. And just here on your back and take a deep breath in for me. Everything sounds just fine. Your heart is very strong and healthy. Good. And I'm just going to take your blood pressure. I'm going to be very careful not to get near your shoulder wound, okay? But just make sure to relax. Stick and just follow it with your eyes and try not to move your head, okay? Good. So I'm just going to start here and just follow along with your eyes, okay? medical issues from that wound, from the impact. Mm-hmm. I think you're going to be fine in no time at all. Just going to feel here. Okay. There's a lot of tenderness here, right? Okay. Just let me know when you feel any sort of sharp pain or kind of discomfort. A little bit here. Okay. Yeah. And how's this side here? I'm just going to get some cream for your shoulder and try and loosen up some of these knots, okay? So I'm going to really massage here around your shoulder area. Just try and relax as best you can. Okay. Good. We just want to make sure we relax everything, especially when you've had a nightmare and things start to tense up. Yeah, we don't want any shell shock, okay? Down your arm, okay? Good. Feeling a lot better. I'm happy. Good. And we're going to keep on doing those exercises. Yes, exercising is crucial. It'll help you. Exercise and getting the blood flow going is better for you during the day. You're making me all flush. Everything is looking very good. Your wound is all cleaned out and the ointment is perfectly applied. Your bandage is nice and placed. It's fresh and it will definitely protect you from anything around these areas. You're healing very well. Your shoulder is so much stronger than it was. I'm very, very happy. Keep on doing those exercises and try to hydrate as much as you can. And most importantly, get some rest at nighttime. Okay. I'll see you again very soon. Take care of yourself. All right. How deep the Father's love for us. How vast beyond all measure that he should give his only son to make rich his treasure. How great the pain of searing loss the Father turned his face away as wounds which